My name is Antonio. I've been playing Magic for a while. That's about it.
Hi, my name is Stephen Menendian. I'm playing in my first Pro Tour. Pretty excited.
My name is Sean Connor. I'm a player from Sarasota, Florida.
My name is Sam Stein.
Hi, I'm Antoine Rudolph.
I'm John Fiorillo.
Hello, I'm Raphael Levy.
Hi, Mike Rohn.
My name is Adrian Sullivan.
I'm Rémi Fauché. I'm 16. I'm French.
What's up? I'm Zach Hill, Chatter from the United States, representing Star City.
Hell yeah, absolutely.
I'm Jacob Van Luden.
My name's Jason Terry.
I'm Melissa Natora.
Hello, I'm Olivia Oven.
Hi, I'm Paulo Vitor Domino Rosa.
Hi, I'm Randy Bueller.
I am Rob Doherty, Magic Pro Player, Hall of Famer, and Star City Games writer.
Okay. If we have to, we can run a two-day Pro Tour, which is like a Grand Prix. And we can run a two-day event.
Okay.
But like, for example, my flight's already on Sunday morning.
Well, you do really well on day one, like a Grand Prix, and you make the cut to day two.
It's your decision.
It's your decision what you want to do about your flight.
But, I mean, that's like, you know, it wasn't, you know, my fault that I was putting myself in this decision.
Yeah, but it's not our fault either.
No, it's, but it is if you decide to run it.
Talk to that person.
It is if you decide to run it.
So what other options do you want us to make?
I mean, I don't know. I'm not in your situation, but not an option where ever. I mean, I'm not definitely not the only person who's got a flight.
Oh, no, we already know.
You already know. Sure, yeah, exactly. I'm sure you guys realize.
The best option we can do is run as many rounds as we can tomorrow.
Sure.
Make a cut so that people can make that decision. And then go.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the best we can do.
Basically, when we got out here at 1:30, this night, and there was like 10 to 15 centimeters of water here, right where we're standing now.
Oh my God.
And wading from over there to here and getting into the side and the water in the side, it was pretty much canceled. This night, when I got back to the hotel about 3 a.m.,
yeah,
there were like 10 people, WOTC people, sitting there like discussing options. We want this to be still a Pro Tour. We want still there to be a tournament because, yeah, we want the results to be there, but we need to keep check of everything else as well.
We understand that players like Basic Land, and the only thing that players like more than Basic Land is boosters. We know that this is true, and you know, there are some issues. Like, maybe there are like 50,000 boosters in a lake.
Well, this is all very entertaining, isn't it? And, you know, it's Mr. Irwin's fault. You know that, right? You see, the Invitational, that's fine. No one minds him being invited to that. But when they said, why don't you come to the Pro Tour? That's it. The Pro Tour's gone. It's history. Irwin does it again. Scandalous. Scandalous. In fact, I don't think I'm going to talk to you anymore. I'm really not. It's like, bye.
I was pretty excited because the night before we just decided to test the Enduring Ideal matchup for like 4 hours. So I went to sleep at 3. I'm like, oh, I gotta get up at 6:30. This is awesome. Bill Star comes into our room like a dad at summer camp. He's just like, boys, don't wake up. It's okay. It's been canceled. I was like, so I'm not too disappointed about that. I mean, 10 rounds in a day sucks. But like, Wizards has done a really good job of like making this happen considering
you know, we walked home in the rain for 50 minutes. We knew how bad it was. And like, given that there was standing water in the floor, I can't believe this is even happening. So I can't complain about what's going on at all. I see a lot of people are like, oh my God, I hate this. You know, I was so prepped on day one. I was like, well, I wasn't, so sucks for you.
That was awful, really. I think one of the things for the people that did a lot of work, they came here and they were ready. And I know a lot of people switch decks. A lot of people not only switch decks, but fixed decks, because they get here. And this is not a pro tour where there anyone, I don't think anyone had any high tech, advanced, secret things going on. Maybe by the end of the weekend we'll find out differently. But for most people, there was nothing high tech. It was honing, it was low tech stuff like, oh, I run careful study times three, you know, instead of times four and dredge. It was all very small changes. So suddenly, the person that's not as ready shows up, and they're not quite sure about their deck. Everyone's fine with playing out openly because the Pro Tour might not even happen, and no one's got secret tech, and everyone's deck that wasn't as good just got better. And I felt really prepared for this event, so that's bad for me and anyone else that felt bad or felt prepared for the event.
That was weird. I mean, it hasn't ever happened before. We've had terrorist attacks in London, the subways blew up, didn't cancel day one, the blizzard in New York didn't cancel day one. It's just, I mean, it happens, I guess, but yeah. It's weird.
It was kind of obnoxious. I felt in a lot of ways like it hurt my chances, because I was playing, like, I'm playing Domain Zoo, and I feel like there would have been a lot more like rock archetypes and like mid-range archetypes that I could have really taken advantage of in the fields had people not had that extra day of testing.
It's kind of crazy, but I don't think it's going to make that much of a difference. I think it kind of gave everyone a day to relax and just chill. So I think on the whole, it's actually a good thing.
It's pretty interesting. I like wasn't that mad. It was kind of nice. Yeah. You know, we kind of had extra time to hang out and enjoy the city. So other people I know are pretty upset, but it doesn't really change my plans much. So I was all right with it.
It was probably the right thing to do. I didn't like it particularly, but I don't think it changes the product too much.
It was too surprised. All wizard stuff, confused, and Hakon said, it's not a joke, not a joke.
No, I didn't change a card. I just got some more games in, which is always helpful. And it's good because everyone has their deck set, like kind of know what they want to play, and they have their sideboard ready, so you could play some real matches as if you were there. So it's helpful, you know?
Yeah, I changed my deck because of it. I was going to play a Tog deck that I wasn't really happy with, but Quentin Martin gave me a Tron deck, and so playing that now.
I actually did. I think the extra time, it was... I mean, I made good use of it, and I think everyone else did as well. I mean, you have a time to like sit there and like kind of scope out other decks and see what actually is being coming out in numbers. So like, it affected my sideboard big time.
Yeah.
How so?
After the deck on sale, I had the UI Tron, but I tested with Jonathan Whisper and Yemo Futaba, and I chose to play the same deck like Jonathan Whisper because it feels good. And I like it.
Well, actually, the only thing I might change is my side where I thought about it more, and that actually ended up being maybe the deciding factor. A lot of my matches were based on my sideboard, so.
My deck, designed by Tom Haru Saito. Mm-hmm. Saito said, it's excellent, no change.
Awesome.
You know, I've heard a lot of people grumbling about that, but that's just sour grapes, I think. And that person that was like, you know, on the bubble that might not have made it, and he's playing in the Pro Tour, he's going to be, you know, really happy. He's going to be excited, and you can bet all of his friends are going to hear about how he got to play the Pro Tour.
Absolutely. Yeah. So it's good for Magic.
Oh, it's great for Magic. The people that are complaining about that, I don't think that they quite understand what it is that this event here is for. It's not for the people that are playing, it's for everyone else.
Well, yeah, that kind of made me mad since there was 19 more people taking up the slots and the money, but I guess they have to do it like that. They can't just say, sorry.
I think it was generous. I don't think it's going to, you know, make the tournament too ridiculous. I mean, it's a large tournament, that's not because of the LCQ, so that doesn't bother me, you know? I mean, and congratulations to them. I hope one of them top eight.
That's good. You're happy with
19
that?
More people playing the Pro Tour. Yeah. 19 more happy persons.
Yeah.
Like, I think 400 people are too much for a Pro Tour. So 400 and 420, that's the same.
Just glad for those people who qualified, who came like from France, Italy. Mm-hmm. It's a good thing.
That was good luck for them. I mean, you know, I guess it takes a natural disaster, right?
I thought it probably up my chances, like, you know, better chance of playing against someone who's probably not on the top level. And the funny thing is, in the last round playing, before I was able to draw in, I played against a guy who was in the last chance qualifier. So that was pretty nice. He was a pretty decent player, but, you know, it wasn't like, you know, one of the top pros that played flawlessly. So it was nice.
That must have been a huge miss. I mean, I don't really mind. I guess plenty of players were very happy for this opportunity. Mm-hmm. As shocked as they might have been when the water first started flooding the site, they were probably pretty glad that I was going to get to play in the Pro Tour, if there was going to be a Pro Tour. Mm-hmm. So for those, it probably was good. And as for the rest of the tournament, the I don't know, the last chance people tend to not make a lot of impact because they weren't qualified coming in and they also didn't get much sleep.
Exactly.
So I didn't mind.
I don't know if that's good or bad, because like a lot of the people that I've seen, like I had to play against one of them round one, and he made like a lot of blunders. Like he was waiting for his third land, because I had three Curd Apes in play, and he throws the Polluted Delta, and he plays the Polluted Delta, and he just taps one mana and plays Engineered Explosives for one before he pops the Delta. So stuff like that, like a lot of like iffy mistakes. And then he went to like Sack and kill my things, and I was like, oh, the Ancient Grudge in my graveyard, like.
Yeah.
So, and then he was like, no, it's a land, you can't respond to it. I was like, no. That's not how this works, so.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I'd have to say so. I mean, you play it in anything. If you have green, you just jam it in there and it's good, so.
If it's not, it's damn close. I mean, Psychotog is really good, Tarmogoyf is really good, and it just got better with the new set. I mean, I'm not sure what you'd throw up against it. Maybe it is. Yeah, probably. I don't know. I don't think so.
What is?
I don't know. I like Dark Confident a lot.
Yeah?
And Tarmogoyf is just a creature.
Yeah.
It attacks, it blocks. I mean, it's pretty good, but I don't think it's the best creature.
Maybe. I never thought about that. It was out of it, but now maybe Tarmogoyf is better, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Probably.
You think so?
I wanna say Dark Confidant, but he's better. So he's the best creature ever printed, yeah.
No. That's stupid. Like, okay, Tarmogoyf is really good. Like, Tarmogoyf is the best card in Future Sight, probably, and also the most overrated card in Future Sight. Like, people put it into every deck, but they have to remember it's a creature with power and toughness. Like, and that's all it is. Not every deck needs a dude with power and toughness. Like, we cut it from our deck. Like, we were originally wishing for it just because it was huge. We're like, wait. Like, we need cards that do specific things. I mean, so best creature, I mean, I think when Wild Mongrel was nuts, Wild Mongrel was better. I think Psychotog's better. And I think, like, you know, something stupid like Goblin Welder is probably better. But I mean, Tarmogoyf is certainly up there. It's a duder, you know. I mean, he's nuts, but he's, at the end of the day, he attacks and blocks. Sometimes that's not good enough.
To practice. It's only every day practice. Of course, Magic, I always love to say Magic is a game of luck and skill. You need to play good, so that means practice. Choose a deck and play that, especially in a format that is very wide open. Stick to a deck and learn to play it as good as possible. The meta game is usually pretty much rock, paper, scissors, so it doesn't depend if you take rock or paper or scissors, it doesn't matter. As long as you don't lose with scissors against paper, you're good. So try to get your skill up to that minimum level and then you're pretty much set. Try to get enough sleep the night before. Many people just don't sleep at all, and that makes a huge difference. When you get up, you really wanna, like, you wanna play the PDQ and you want to be able to win it and not be like falling asleep after round 5. And also play many PDQs. If you go to one PDQ, you're probably not going to win it. There's 50 or 100 or 200 competitors and one or two will get the slot. So what you need to do is you need to try again and again and again. Try going everywhere, try going to GPs also. There are great ways to qualify for the PT. Just try getting there and one day you'll get there.
It's tough because I remember I would play PDQs and, you know, sometimes I would do well in the PTQ, sometimes I wouldn't. And I just really wanted to qualify. And I mean, it's a good feeling to qualify. And, you know, you can't take Magic too serious because otherwise it's just not good. You just have to remember it's all about, like, the friends you make and just, like, the fun times and just the people you meet and stuff is is what Magic's really about. I mean, it's pretty tough to win. I mean, I played like my last six Pro Tours. I didn't win any money, and I mean, it's still common stuff because I'm qualified, and it's still fun. So I mean, just I guess maybe one day I'll win or something. If not, it's not that big of a deal.
I made top 32 of Grand Prix a few times. One top 16. That's how I qualified for this. So I guess I do okay. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. Hopefully, like I can get more Pro Tour experience and qualify for the Pro Tours. I've been playing since high school. Like it's so much fun. I've been a gamer all my life, so I love it. Yeah, I mean, like if you look at the MSS, you see a lot more girls, and that's a good sign because hopefully that would mean that more girls are going to be playing. Yeah, I've been playing for a while. I've been playing for like 10 years. I don't really have much success on the Pro Tour or anything. This is my fifth one. I've never made money. I made day two once, but...
Well, I mean, with your current record, you're on your way.
Yeah, I have to go 2-1 to make day two, so hopefully I can do that.
Vote for Gerard Fabiano next year, Invitational Storyteller, all right?
That's serious. Right. I'll vote for you, man.
All right, thanks.